Hi traders, it's Chris Wesson here, Head of Research at Pepperstone. So we're back once again looking at the gold market, looking at all the various facets that are going on, the rhythm, the feel, the structure, the price action, the event risk coming up, so we can make informed decisions about what's happening in the gold market. And it has been a good week to be long gold. It's not been spectacular. There's an eerie calm that seems to have descended on the gold market. We'll have a look at the ranges playing through. But I think we've got some catalysts coming up on the horizon, and it wouldn't be surprising if we did see a bit of a move higher or lower into the volatility picking up a little bit in the short term. One thing that we have taken out is that gold in US dollar terms is up 0.4% over the last 5 days. Gold in Aussie dollar terms has been slightly better bang for your buck if you're long, because the Aussie dollar has been the weakest currency in G10 over the last 5 days. If you have a look at the charts of gold in Aussie dollar terms, which I've got playing through here, you can see a situation where we looked last week at buying gold into the 38.2% retracement. That seems to have worked pretty well. The market had this really strong rally. It was overbought. We saw the pin bar reversal playing through into the 38.2% retracement. So we looked to buy gold into that. So anyone who watched the video last week will remember that. And that seems to have done quite well, because we've seen an explosive move out of the blocks. It feels to me that this has room to squeeze. If the Aussie dollar remains one of the weaker currencies going forward, and maybe some of the equity market volatility in China will continue to play into that, as well as some of the domestic conditions around what's happening in the city, lockdowns, then there's a possibility that over the coming week or two, then you're going to see that squeeze up into 2,500. So being long of Aussie dollar terms has been the best trade so far in terms of gold. And I think, you know, that feels like it's got momentum. You can see that the market's moving up quite nicely there. So I think any kind of pullbacks in Aussie dollar gold continues to be a good place to be. If we have a look at gold in US dollar terms, though, you can see that once again last week, we were looking for gold to trade into the 1797.90 range. It seems to continue to work really well. There's a lot of buying support that's playing into this sort of buy zone. Until that gives way, you know, we continue to look to buy dips into those areas. If it does pull back and break through on a closing basis, and I emphasize the word closing basis, on a daily basis, then I think, you know, you've obviously got a real risk that this trades into 1750 down into those lows. But you can just see how important this level of bids are in the market here. But what we've seen after the Fed meeting, and what I took out from the Fed meeting that we saw overnight, was a situation that they're really in no rush. They're seeing progress, but it's not substantial progress. So I took out that the Q4 is going to be the period we're going to get a formal announcement as to their asset purchase program, which is currently running split over US Treasuries and mortgage-backed securities, $120 billion a month. I think that we're looking at the November meeting, but probably more likely the December meeting, given that's when they're going to be handing out their new economic projections and Fed pump, or the dot plot projections as well. So I don't think there are any kind of major rush, and that's had implications on rates and fixed income as well. And I think once they actually formally announce it, there probably won't be too much volatility, because it will be so well priced in. But have a look at what we've been seeing. Bullish outside day reversal after the Fed meeting. The bulls have stepped in after making a new low, and they've closed firmly above the prior day's high. Now what we're seeing is the follow through buying there. So we really like that. It's a change of ownership. It tells me there's some momentum playing through in the gold market. The 200-day moving average is obviously your first level of resistance, but as you saw back here, it didn't necessarily mean a lot. It's how price reacts into these numbers that you're looking for. The key level then we're looking for is this swing high that we got back on the 15th of July, 1834. That would be the level that you'd be looking for potential supply to come in. And if we have a look at the options market, and if we have a look at the weekly straddle pricing and what, you know, the options traders who are buying and selling volatility, well, the levels there are 1840 down to 1789. So I would be looking, if we saw a continuation of this bullish move, 1840 would be a level on the week that I think potentially that we could see the market reverse. We could see some better supply. So I think anything above that level for me on the week would be where I'll be looking for mean reversion shorts and looking to try and, you know, fade some of that strength that we've been seeing, unless the news really warranted it. Looking ahead, what's the big piece of news? Well, it's going to be payrolls on Friday. Next week, we've got non-farm payrolls numbers. Now, the playbook around that is, you know, the market's looking for about 960,000 jobs, which is a massive number. But is that further evidence of substantial progress, which, of course, is the Fed's litmus test? I think a number north of a million would be, you know, quite nicely US dollar positive. It would mean that bond yields, both nominal and real rates, would be going higher, and that would weigh on the gold price as well. That said, if we have a look at a number, you know, lower than 800,000, where the market's probably discounting 900 or 1,000, then you're going to get a situation where the US dollar is probably going to continue weakening, real rates will head lower, and that probably won't meet the substantial progress test. Of course, we're looking at other areas like the participation rate. What's the unemployment rate going to be? Is it going to tick down from 5.9 to 5.7%, which is what it's expected? And also looking at the U6 rate, you know, the most broad measure of unemployment the Fed looks at very closely. Will that continue to tick down, showing that slack's coming out of the labor market? It's not just as simple as saying, you know, what's the headline level of jobs, but that's going to be the big one. And that's what the playbook around gold, and that's what all the gold traders are going to be looking at next week. It does feel that this could squeeze a little bit higher, as it does with the Aussie dollar gold as well. Let's have a look at the intraday ranges. What I've got here is a chart of the daily ranges. I've looked at the high and low, and I've subtracted the high from the low, and I've looked at that as a percentage from the previous day's close. And you can see the ranges that we've got on the daily basis. And what I've got is a five-day moving average, just to show you the range. We could use statistical volatility, but that works on a close-to-close basis. By using the full range, which of course we're all involved with, we're involved with the gold market 24 hours a day, not on a close-to-close basis, you can see the moving average of the daily ranges is now really trading at the lowest levels, well, since April, and you know, probably the lowest levels of the year, really, almost. So as I said, there's an eerie calm that's playing through in the gold market, and those ranges are contracting. Could that be a situation that that we are going to see a more explosive move? Have a look at this chart again. I like this chart because it really shows that gold has been underperforming real rates. If you have a look at inflation-adjusted 10-year treasury yields, they're at the lowest level ever. I continue to talk about how important this is for the gold market. Traditionally, this has had a very strong relationship with gold. I've actually flipped gold upside down. So you can see through this period here that gold's actually going up as real yields are going down. Gold has no yield. So, of course, in a situation where real yields are becoming more and more deeper negative, gold's store of value is reinforced. Now, that broke down in mid-June, as you can see there. The question is, are we now going to see a period of catch-up? I talk about this every week, but real yields now at negative 117 basis points. It's telling us a pretty dark message about the US and global economy that perhaps not being shared by the equity markets at the moment. Real yields are a sense of what's happening in economic conditions. And you can see a situation there where that's getting more negative. The question is will gold now mean revert? If that was to close completely, we would be seeing gold around about 2,000. So it's not going to catch up overnight. But the fair value based on this previous correlation is around 2,000 for gold. You can also see the relationship that real rates have got with the US dollar. And you can see another situation where the US dollar is playing catch up to real rates as well. So if they continue to head lower, then the gold price is going higher. The US dollar is going lower. And that's going to be driven by what we've been seeing in payrolls next week. So taking a step back, you know, positioning's good. You know, we've got 109,000 contracts. The market's quite long of gold, but it's not that long. Our clients are generally pretty long of gold. We've got, 56% of clients who are holding long positions at the moment, 44% who are short. So it's a bit mixed. Usually they're much more bullish on gold than what we've been seeing. But the positioning at the moment is pretty positive. We're looking for gold to potentially trade up into those recent highs, perhaps into 1840. Payrolls is going to be the big one. If we see further deeper negative real yields, then of course gold's only going to go one way. If we do see a reversal, then of course we're going to see some weakness playing through. But my bet at the moment, given the price action we're seeing, is that gold's got some upside in the short term. But as always, keep gold on the radar and trade it with Pepperstone.